Welcome back to this News 19 special report, Pain and Suffering, the Opioid Story. There's a strong message from the CDC. Addiction is a medical condition, treatment can help, and recovery is possible. A Huntsville man says active recovery for opioid addiction is a constant commitment, but he says it's well worth it. News 19's Emily Mosner walks us through Deke Damson's journey from drug use to a fulfilling life in recovery.
These days, Huntsville local Deke Damson runs his businesses, spends time with family, and serves on the board of directors for Not One More Alabama, a support group for people and families struggling with addiction. Damson himself is in recovery after a long battle with drug use.
I started out, in high school with Quaaludes, 40 years ago. I would take just about anything, to get high.
He says he took some time off from using until he discovered something new.
Later in life, I had a few surgeries and I was introduced to opioids through the surgeries, and that set me off again. I would get a bottle that said take one every 6 hours, and I'd take six every 1 hour. I could not follow the prescription, and so probably for the last 10 years of my active addiction, it was mainly opioids.
Damson says in the throes of addiction, he would just take more and more and more.
I would draw the line in the sand. Well, I'm never going to do that. And then I would erase that line and I would draw a new line a little farther out because I had done whatever I said I wasn't going to do.
Now, he's been in recovery since October 6th of 2019. Despite family and friends urging him to get help sooner, he says it was hard to get there.
My ego told me that, I was married, I had a successful business, I had a good job, I had a house, I hadn't lost all my stuff. I had to get to that point myself to where I was sick and tired of being sick and tired, and that I wanted to live without drugs more than I wanted to live with drugs.
Eventually, he went to a treatment center where he spent 60 days recovering from the physical damage caused by drugs. Addiction also brings a mental battle that can take longer to overcome.
It's a struggle. It's, when you have a little pill or a little powder or a little something that is constantly calling your name and telling you, hey, come do me, I'll make it all better.
Now, he takes it day by day.
There's certain things I have to do on a daily basis to surrender to that and to stay, sober on a daily basis. Now, obviously, the longer that, I stay sober, the easier it gets. But, I mean, it was a struggle for probably the first year.
Damson says support groups have helped him. He says being able to talk to other people going through a similar battle can help.
They've been through it and they can help you get through it. I'll just say, just don't be ashamed, reach out and ask for help before it's too late.
Damson says Not One More Alabama is a helpful resource for not only the people struggling with addiction, but their families as well.
We try to give all the information we can to people who are in a situation with a loved one that is in active addiction. We have family support groups. We have the End Addiction Walk that we do every year in Big Spring Park.
He says the best way to help a loved one dealing with addiction is to show them love.
Don't shame us. We're our own worst enemy, so when we do something and we get caught, you can't make us feel any worse, so don't pile on.
Damson says there is a clear distinction between being in recovery and addiction.
In active addiction, we all check off of a list of things we said we would never do. In recovery, we check off a list of things that we never believe were possible that we could do.
He urges anyone who may be struggling to get help and to not give up.
Give recovery a chance. Stick around, give it a chance. And I think that you will find that you will live your best life that you ever dreamed that you would live in recovery. I know I am.
In Huntsville, Emily Mosner, News 19.